So the idea came from Juha Raivio and Helena, who is playing on the string section on the album, and they kind of envisioned the whole bonus album.
I contacted Juha Raivio in the beginning of the year for an upcoming project with this string trio, Trio Nox, for another project, and that project didn't happen with Raivio, but then he was in the middle of writing the songs, the strings for the real album, and then he just got this crazy idea and he asked me, like, would this be completely crazy? Like, do you think it would it work? And I just thought, let's do it.
So then we started thinking that what would be a good place to record, and I asked the string section, what is the best sounding place you have ever played in? And the Church of Sipoo might be one of those places. And Juha Raivio was really excited about recording here, so.
It's been absolutely fantastic because everyone is really nice to work with, and even though we're tired at the end of the day and, you know, our cellist's fingers are almost broken from playing so intensely for 13 hours, it's still, everybody kind of musters up the energy to just, you know, finish it and do a good job. So it's been memorable, basically the whole thing. It's been just wonderful, and of course this space is just fantastic and the sound is absolutely amazing.
The bonus album is going to be released before the actual album, and it's never been done before, I don't think, but it's going to be a really nice experience to see what people are going to get from the string album, because it's going to be like this foreshadowing to the actual album. So I think it will be really nice for the fans.
This hasn't been done before. I mean, there are some albums, Metallica has done SSM, where they have done afterwards the string arrangement with a big orchestra, but I don't think it's ever been done this way, that the string arrangements are published first before the actual album.
Such an honor to participate also in this instrumental album with these highly talented musicians, which I have to say, it's really great that it was four ladies who played this whole instrumental album from the doom metal music.
The new album is going to be as emotional as the earlier stuff, and that's kind of Juha Raivio's style to put his emotions in the songs.
It was really interesting to see what kind of songs are hiding underneath this doom metal versions, underneath all the distortion and electronic instruments.
Yeah, Swallow the Sun is definitely wonderfully doomy, and the string versions are, of course, you can't, we don't have basses, we don't have guitars, we don't have the really, really low and like electrical long sounding things. We have to do it in other ways, but how can we simulate that using the string instruments? What has been absolutely fantastic was that Juha was kind enough to send me the demo version of the heavy metal album, so that then you can actually hear the lyrics to the songs, and then you kind of understand the string versions better, and you know what kind of mood you have to try to create with only strings without any words, so that if we succeed, in the best case, people will kind of be able to guess what the lyrics will be in a specific part, if we really can kind of nail the perfect emotion there.
I think they have some sort of magical touch. The touch that can cure people. You can get comfort. You can listen to them when you're sad or you just want to listen to something beautiful.